Many animals, such as bats, use sound to communicate with each other. Bats also use sound to get information about their surroundings in the dark. Bats use their ears to see in the dark. As you know, they use their ears for something called echolocation.
Echolocation.
Where bats make a high-pitched sound and then listen for an echo or reflected sound. When the bat hears the reflected sound, it knows that there is something nearby. Bats use echoes to tell where and how far away objects are.
Scientists have been inspired by this adaptation to find ways to help blind people detect their surroundings. Have you ever known someone who could not see because they were blind?
Yes.
Scientists have created a cane that emits a high-pitched sound.
Just like bats do.
Yes, the sound's pitch is too high for humans to hear.
This special cane then uses vibrations to communicate information about the world to the person using it.
Can you explain more?
As a person is walking with the cane, an echo from the sound is picked up by the cane. The echo is turned into vibrations that the person can feel with their thumb. The similarities between blind person and bat echolocation. That the special cane of blind person and bats emit a high-pitched sound. This special cane and bats receive the echo that can tell how far away objects.
And the differences between the blind person and bat echolocation that the special cane picks up an echo from the sound it emits and changes it into a vibration. Bats pick up an echo from the sound they emit, but they don't change it to vibrations.
How are the cane and the honeybee dance similar?
The vibrating buttons tell the person the direction of the obstacles around them and how close the object is to them. By the same way honeybee dance to inform the location of the flower.
And the human can move alone without support.
Yes, you are excellent.
In the next video, we will talk about Unit 1 Project Chattering Bats. Don't forget to subscribe and share the video to your friends. Goodbye.